Let's go! You guys, you're not going to believe what Myles Brennan said to the media today regarding his injury, his rehab, his outlook. I am loving it, baby. Also, quite a few players spoke to the media, but one really stood out. So go on ahead, subscribe to the channel, come to the live streams. Let's get to it. The first thing, and this was the most newsworthy thing of everything, Myles Brennan's injury was so rare that doctor said, I've never done surgery on this. So we're naming the surgery after you if you wanted to. And Myles Brennan said he didn't really feel comfortable with that, which is why he didn't have the surgery. And Myles Brennan continued. He said that it happened early in that Missouri game. It was when he threw a touchdown to Terrace Marshall. We did a film study breaking down all those plays where he took tough hits. So if you want to see it, I'll link it down below. But, you know, he said that all his adrenaline was rushing, and he still went on to throw for over 400 yards, which is pretty freaking insane. Now, remember, Myles Brennan in the first spring practice, Ed Orgeron said Max Johnson took the first team reps. This quarterback battle is not done. In fact, you're going to hear what Kayshon Boutte has to say about the quarterback battle a little bit later. But look, Myles Brennan was really, really, really hurt, and he decided to not have the surgery because he said all these doctors said that they've never seen anything like this rib injury that he suffered. So that is pretty freaking insane. Everything that Myles Brennan has gone through with the waiting and the waiting and the more waiting, and, you know, some former players saying that they don't think he's going to be all that great before he ever even had a chance to took a snap. And then even after the Mississippi State game, there's a lot of people saying, well, we know why Jamar decided to sit out this season. Did you see Myles Brennan when he actually threw the ball pretty well, all things considered, against Mississippi State, especially considering his pocket presence got better in the next two games, and his pass protection was decent at best. So, you know, you kind of feel for Myles Brennan just a little bit. So I thought it was great that he got to speak to the media and say that he's 100% healthy. This is the first time we've heard from him since the Missouri game. So obviously you guys have read some quotes that have been scrolling on the screen. I also want to get to everyone that actually spoke to the media, and it's not just Myles Brennan. It's Ed Ingram, Liam Shanahan, Austin Deculus, Andre Anthony. What do all those guys have in common? Oh, yeah, they're all linemen, okay? This is what Ed Orgeron wants to build. If you go back to his leadership council photo, the photo was mostly offensive and defensive linemen, which to me is great because obviously Ed Orgeron believes football is won in the trenches, especially in the SEC. I tend to believe that as well, and I just think that's great. I do. I like hearing from linemen, and I liked hearing that the offensive linemen are looking to take their game to the next level because obviously they weren't all that good. I believe Austin Deculus said that from 2018 to 2019, the LSU offensive line took a huge jump. They went from an inconsistent group in 2018 to the Joe Moore Award-winning offensive line in 2019. Then in 2020, they took another step back, and they're looking to take another huge step forward in 2021 with all the returning starters. So it's also interesting that those three linemen spoke. I think there's no mystery that those three guys are going to start. Liam Shanahan at center, Ed Ingram at left guard. It's going to be interesting what they do with Austin Deculus. I do think they'll keep him at right tackle. So I liked hearing from all those guys. I thought that was phenomenal. Andre Anthony, his big highlight was saying the following: communication was the number one issue. Now, he also said that he and Ali Gay have been holding each other accountable, which is obviously really good. Andre Anthony is now 25 years old, which is pretty old for a college football player. But legit, the communication thing is very important because that was the biggest issue on LSU's defense last year. They were never on the same page, and they gave up all these explosive plays. So I think that is really good that Andre Anthony and Durante Jones have figured out that the major problem last year was communication and basic fundamentals, which is something that needs to get fixed before we start next season. However, I've already mentioned his name. The most important player that spoke to the media, in fact, was the youngest player that spoke to the media today. So here he is, folks. The stud, Kayshon Boutte. There's a lot of reasons why this was very important. Number one is you want your best players to be leaders. Now, we discussed this a few weeks ago with the Leadership Council video that we did. It was interesting that the players that were there were on the Leadership Council, but the three best players on the team are not on Leadership Council, and that is Kayshon Boutte, Derek Stingley Jr., and Eli Ricks. Now, they might be on there and they weren't at the dinner. I don't know. There's no official ledger of Leadership Council members, but when you speak to the media, you're speaking to the media on behalf of LSU. You're speaking on behalf of the team. You're speaking on behalf of everyone. So that is something that holds you accountable. You are a representative of the university. And by speaking to the media, I think that helps out a player's personal responsibility. I really do. The summer of 10,000 catches is back under DJ Mangus. Kayshon Boutte says, I'm at 5,400 right now. And here's a further quote here from Jared Roser. That was Brooks Cabuena. Kayshon Boutte says he thinks he's had 5,400 balls caught so far, and Coy Moore is up to 6,500. That is pretty impressive. Now, we've talked about this on live streams in the past, that Julie Baldwin has said that that Coy Moore was the hardest working football player she's ever seen, which is pretty freaking cool to think about, because she's covered a lot of great football players. So, yeah, I mean, Coy Moore's work ethic is well noted, and Kayshon putting in this level of work is really good as well. Now, he said this: the goal for LSU's wide receivers now was 5,000 and 10,000 during the offseason overall. Now, do they count every single catch that is thrown from a jug machine or whatever? I'm not sure. It could just be a saying. But, you know, whether or not you like it or not, a lot of athletes throw those numbers out there, whether it be Kobe or whoever, shooting 10,000 free throws in a day or whatever the number may be. It's more important that you set that number and you try to achieve it. And if you just keep working, those reps make you a better football player. So that is good to see. And for those that don't remember the significance of the number 10,000, the summer of 10,000 catches was something that Joe Brady brought to the LSU team in the summer of 2019. Coy Moore, who, as you see, has put in 6,500 catches, Trey Palmer, and, of course, Jontre Kirkland. All three of those guys were the three leaders in drop percentage on LSU last season, and it was by a pretty wide margin, those three guys and everyone else. So, yeah, this is something that LSU desperately needs to work on because there were far too many drops in 2020. So, a few things from today's practice. This video was shot by Brody Miller of The Athletic. So, first thing here, Jake Peets not only working with the quarterbacks, this is John Emery in a gold non-contact uniform. So, for those that don't know, when you wear a gold non-contact jersey, you are not allowed to hit them, which is weird because, you know, normally it's just quarterbacks, but you can't hit anyway because they're not in pads right now. But that's not here nor there. This individual drill, they were throwing to all the different running backs, and all four of the quarterbacks were throwing to the running backs. And this is Garrett Nussmeier. So I'm not going to actually play the video, but I will send you a few of these screenshots. Okay, and this is John Emery going out on the route. The throw from Garrett Nussmeier was on the money, and John Emery dropped it. Once again, like I said in yesterday's video, If you want to watch yesterday's, well, it's actually 2 days ago. If you want to watch our video from yesterday breaking down practice footage, you can find it down below. Don't take too much from any one practice. Here's another clip here. The wide receivers getting some work here with DJ Mangus, and this is, of course, Jeray Jenkins. However, the funniest thing that happened from practice today involved Big Mason Smith. Here's another individual drill. This is Ed Orgeron. This is Glenn Logan. And this is Mason Smith. And, of course, Ed Orgeron coaching up the defensive tackles while Andre Carter works with the defensive ends here in the background. Okay. So now this is just, you know, a simple walkthrough drill of how to fight up against a double team. Here's Ed Orgeron right here. We continue to the next slide. And notice Glenn Logan gets a good piece of Mason Smith right here. Ed Orgeron still coaching him up. And in fact, he threw Mason Smith kind of to the ground. It wasn't really all that violent. I think it was more them losing their balance. And Ed Orgeron said in the background, "Welcome to LSU, big boy." And here in the background is defensive ends getting some work here with Andre Carter. So, you know, we might go through more of this practice footage in our video tomorrow, but this is a cool insight on the little bit that the media got to see at the LSU practice. So we hope you like this video. Obviously, don't forget about live streams Tuesdays and Saturdays. It is Power Hour LSU Boom! Guys, I'm a little scared. Hey said she's trying some garlic parmesan salmon tonight. Because the mustard-based salmon is so good, I'm a little worried about it tonight because you guys know how much I love that salmon.